www.ifa.org/donate.
واشهد ان لا اله الا الله وحده لا شريك له واشهد ان محمدا عبد الله ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى اله وصحبه وسلم وبعد. يا ايها الذين امنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن الا وانتم مسلمون. يا ايها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحده وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد, always and forever we begin with the praise of Allah. We send our prayers of peace upon our Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We testify with firmness and conviction that none is worthy of worship but Allah, and that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his worshipping slave and final messenger. I always remind myself and you of taqwallah azza wa jal. I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us an inner sincerity and an inward awakening where we love Him and adore Him and fear Him and have hope in His mercy in a greater capacity than that which we seek to demonstrate and to portray to others in our public life. Allahumma ameen. Ibadallah, this is one of the most sacred days in the most sacred times of the most sacred months. We have gathered from our various places, various countries, various time zones, coming as a Muslim ummah, as a nation of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with our variety of color, language, ethnicity, age, abilities, gender, coming with one specific purpose, in one specific action, seeking to recreate what was done as a precedent for us by the best of people, with the best of generations, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa sahbihi, in a place similar to where you are seated, and in a day similar to today. Our Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam spoke to our ummah. He spoke a discussion that remains timeless in its message, important in its relevance, and consistent in its theme. He admonishes all of us sallallahu alayhi wa sallam first about our relationship with Allah azza wa jal. And today my discussion with you will revolve around three important points of awakening. Things that you and I know, but in these sacred times and in this sacred site, I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes it an inward awakening that we can carry back to where we have come and touch the hearts of those who have not yet arrived and remind those who have come but have forgotten. Your relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is centered between you, your nafs, and your maker subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you as a unique human being have been blessed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at this moment with an opportunity through life that you still have within you the capacity to come and draw closer to Him azza wa jal. And therefore whenever you would hear from the words of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he would admonish people about their relationship to Allah. He would command them to asking for forgiveness and remind them of the need of repentance. And he would use himself sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as the pristine example. And he would say to them things like sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إِنِّي أَتُوبُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَأَسْتَغْفِرَهُ فِي الْيَوْمِ أَكْثَرَ مِنْ سَبْعِينَ مَرَّةٍ. I personally turn to Allah and ask Him for forgiveness more than 100 times a day. And there's a difference between tawbah and forgiveness. Tawbah is where you know and can put your finger on the thing that has turned you away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, has ruined your relationship between you and Him. And the general asking of istighfar are for the things that are between you and Allah and others that perhaps you're heedless of. And they are silent sins that we have forgotten, that crawl in our life like a dark ant in the depth of the night, silent, but deadly, as described by the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And therefore your mission, as was the mission of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, was to ask both for Allah's forgiveness for the things that we are not sure that we can remember but we know are present, and for the things that we know we're sure of that are in trespasses between us and Allah and mankind, where we must ask specifically for His repentance subhanahu wa ta'ala from them. The essential aspect of your dua today is to earn that place with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, where you begged and asked and come towards your Maker. You ask yourself beginning, why are you here? And why are you dressed this way? And why do you feel this exhaustion? And why have you put a part of your wealth over years to save for this journey? What has brought you in this moment, in this tent, with this group of people who are surrounded by millions and millions of others? What's your purpose for being here today? And it is one specific purpose. It is to gain a standing with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is that you ask Him to absolve you of your errors today and that which are to come into the future. And this isn't something that we take lightly, considering our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's said by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to him, لِيَغْفِرَ لَكَ اللَّهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِكَ وَمَا تَأَخَّرَ. Even you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I have given expiation for what you have done and what you may yet do, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that assurity of being absolved was not for him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in any way that you can claim for yourself. And therefore you stand before Allah, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for His love, for His mercy, for His rahmah. Our Lord the Most High subhanahu wa ta'ala, as is mentioned to us in the authentic hadith, will descend to the nearest heaven. And He will vie subhanahu wa ta'ala in His love for you and I, for those who have come and sought Him and petitioned Him azza wa jal. Allah will show pride in you and speak to the angels of you and I with naming us with our beautiful names. And the Prophet ﷺ says in the authentic hadith, that may Allah make us of them, إِذَا أَحَبَّ اللَّهَ عَبْدًا. When Allah loves an individual, He will summon Jibreel and He will say, يَا جِبْرِيلِ إِنِّي أُحِبُّ فُلَانًا فَأَحِبُّ. Oh Jibreel, I love this person. I command you to love them. And Allah will name you and I by our most loved names to us. Jibreel will grow to love you. And Allah will order Jibreel to call out into the heavens, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ فُلَانًا. Allah loves this man, this woman. And I love this man and this woman. And you are commanded because of the love of Allah to love them. وَتُوضَعُ لَهُ الْقَبُولُ فِي الْأَرْضِ. And after everything in the heavens begins to love you, Allah brings upon this earth a level of protection and love for you. And this is what Allah mentions about Musa alayhi salam. After Allah recounts to how He saved him as a young infant child, a child who has not yet done any act of worship, any good deed, Allah hasn't subhanahu wa ta'ala sheltered him for anything except what would come into his future of good. Allah says, وَأَلْفَيْتُ عَلَيْكَ مَحَبَّةً مِنِّي وَلِتُصْنَعَ عَلَى عَيْنِي. O Musa, I brought down my love upon you. I cloaked you with my love. And you may sit before me today and I sit in front of you as sinners, acknowledging our mistakes before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And at times this may be difficult for you and I to rationalize that the Divine, the Almighty, can love us because of what we know of ourselves. Sins that if they were shared with others, people would turn away from us. And yet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows not just of who you are now, but of why He is loving you for what you will do in the future. And Allah loved Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu even before he came to Islam. And because of that love, he was led to Islam. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would make the dua, O Allah, give victory to Islam with one of the two men you love the most. Subhanallah. Is it Abu al-Hakam ibn Hisham, who we call Abu Jahl, or Umar ibn Khattab? Which one of them you love more, O Allah? Give strength to Islam from them. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam could see that Allah would love a person not for who they are today, but who they develop into the future. And therefore you and I, we sit as sinners today. But after the day of Arafah, we sit as the beloved, as Duyuf al-Rahman. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala seal for us the day of Arafah. You have been brought here by Allah, and therefore you are assured the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Your soul beckons you to ask Him because He has provided for you that hidayah. And every dua that you make, before you've uttered it with your tongue, Allah has heard it in your heart. And Allah will give you what you do not yet know that you need to ask, because of the love that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has for you. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the dua of our Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma inna nas'aluka hubba. Oh Allah, we ask you for your love. Wa hubba man yuhibbuk, and the love of those who love you. Wa hubba al-amal alladhi yuqarribuna ila hubbik, and the love of the deeds that will earn and endear us more to you, oh Allah. The second aspect of the Prophet's words on that day were about our social responsibility. And he began by those who were nearest to us. And he began by admonishing the men in particular to look after our families. Istawsu bin nisa'i khayra. فَإِنَّكُمْ أَخَذْتُمُوهُنَّ بِكَلِمَةِ اللَّهِ. Treat your women well, because you took them with a covenant you made with Allah. Not just their family, not just her father or her brother or her uncle, not just a pact you have with her, each other, but it's sanctioned by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And therefore this is one of the most important relationships highlighted by the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What good is a man who is not good to the one who he shares his life with? What good is a woman who does not honor the one who she has committed her life with? What good is a family that does not build a household for their children ala ususun min at-taqwa, upon foundations of piety and honoring to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And therefore the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam begins from that point source, that it is between you and your family, you and your father, you and your mother, you and your brothers, you and your sisters, you and your aunts and your uncles. And the shuyukh have mentioned to us often in the last few days the importance of our dua being answered by meeting those two conditions. Allah nushrika billah. That you don't take anyone in worship with by Allah. And wallahi, this ihram is a testament of your tawheed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Your talbiyah is a testament of this first part of your dua. But second with it, that you don't break the ties with your family. That you don't have rebellion between you and those who brought you in this world. That you have removed from your heart spite and malice and anger to those who are near in relations to you. And that begins as a point source and radiates outward. It becomes something therefore that includes your neighbors and your friends. And if you're sitting before me today and if you've forgotten your neighbor, Muslim or not, in your dua list, add them. Add them and ask Allah to grant hidayah and correction and good and acceptance of them. It increases out of your neighbors to the neighbor who's distant, to your colleagues and your workmates, to the people who live in your community, to our country, Canada, and where I live at the moment, Australia. You make dua for everything and everyone, that Allah brings rectification and happiness and good and fills the world and lets peace reign. And this was the message of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the third, and finally, before Jilsa of Istiraha, and I take a moment to pause, is that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam commanded our ummah of our duty, not just to those who are near, and not just to those who are a part of us, but to the greater ummah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And as I stand with you here today in the plains of Arafah, I would be remiss in my duty if I don't mention our brothers who are not here, our sisters who are unable to come, our brothers and sisters in the Rohingya who have been oppressed and have been slaughtered, our brothers and sisters in the Central African Republic, our brothers and sisters in Afghanistan who have been brought to points of humiliation and stress, our brothers and sisters in Al-Iraq wa Sham, our brothers and sisters in the occupied territories of Palestine, our brothers and sisters who suffer for no other reason than because they have claimed the same words that you and I repeat today, Allah ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. And as you sit here today, include them in your dua and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make you a source of their relief and a source of their victory. and a source of their honor. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us with strength in this day that we can continue until the nightfall of Maghrib. I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answers each and every one of your dua in that way that is best for you in this life and the next. And I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds you of dua for those who you may have forgotten. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allows those who have forgotten you to remember you on this day. And I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala distinguishes you with a sincerity of heart and a purity of conscience. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala turns to you with His love and His forgiveness. That when He descends with His hosts of the angels, that you are from those whose sight falls upon and He accepts the dua that is in your heart that you have not yet spoken. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير. لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير. لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير. These words were the most often repeated words of our Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. And recognize that your dua in this day has two missions. The first of them is to elevate and magnify the praise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To bear witness that He is the only one who is central in your life. That everything that you ask is from Him. And everything that you fear is by His protection that you will be avenged and you will be saved. That you turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, knowing not just in your heart and not just by statements of word, but by a commitment of conduct, أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَحْدَهُ لَا شَرِيكَ لَهِ that He is the one Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and there is none that you will ever ask and need help from other than Him. Your tawheed begins with that knowledge and familiarity of your Creator. And it must resonate in your heart to a level of certainty, where the doubts that you have, you remove them by asking questions that are brought from knowledge and sources that can quench your thirst for that which will bring you closer, closer and closer to Allah. It continues with an acceptance of what Allah has said that maybe your heart and the shaitan seeks to make you rebel against. And it comes to an iqtiyad where you are bound to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has instructed you. That even if you find difficulty in it, I will do it until I can rationalize it and understand it by the command of Allah and His sunnah of the Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That builds in you a desire to be truthful with Allah. And to be sadiq with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is easier in our day-to-day than maybe it is back home. But this is where we begin that truthful journey with Allah. By shedding our clothes and shedding the outer appearances, where we can camouflage ourselves from others and separate ourselves from others with our elitism. That this is a moment of equality and we are all level between Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And therefore let it be a moment where you develop that truthfulness with Allah azza wa jal. That I am here, O Allah. I petition you and I seek you as the man next to me, as the sister who sits behind me. I ask you, O Allah, with the same way and the same word that they ask for the same things. O Allah, grant me a nearness and a qurba to you. And this increases you to a level of ikhlas, where you begin to have a sincerity between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As you sit outside, and as you find a shady place, and as you leave our tent and it begins to get cooler and cooler as the day progresses, find your ikhlas with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Find a place where it's just you and only your voice with Allah. That it's just you and Him. And know that Allah will identify you from the millions who call Him. Know that Allah hears you and sees you and is aware of you, more of your condition than you are of yourself. And know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala desires you. Had min sa'ilin. Is there anyone who will ask me so that I can give him? Had min mustaghithin. Is there anyone who needs my Savior that I can provide for him? Had min da'i. Is there anyone who supplicates for me? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will seek you. And finally, after your ikhlas, the highest level of your worship of Allah is love. And muhabba. Grow to love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in these few hours. And let that love that you develop today reverberate the rest of your life and touch all the families and all the people you contact into the future. The love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is seen in two ways. The first is adversity. And no one was loved more by Allah than Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, once as he sat in his tent, he heard the people talking about the other prophets. And some said that Musa is the one who spoke to Allah. And Ibrahim is Khalilullah, the best friend of Allah. And he exited upon them sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he said, Ala wa ana Habibullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. All of them are as you described, but I am the beloved of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And through the love you have for Muhammad, you increase in your love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wa alayhi afdalus salat wa atamut tasleem. The love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is accomplished in two ways. A difficult way and an easier way. The difficult way is that you look at every place that Allah says, Inna Allah yuhib. Allah loves where you do this. And they are dozens in number in the Quran and in the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that's a long process for you to develop a change in your conscience, in your personality, in your dealings, that you are assured the love of Allah. The second way, the easier way, is that you love others. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that Allah said, وَجَبَتْ مَحَبَّتِ. My love is a wajib for those who love other people. And therefore you hear the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, الرَّاحِمُونَ يَرْحَمُهُ الرَّحْمَنِ. Those who show compassion are given compassion from the most compassionate Allah. يَرْحَمُ مَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ يَرْحَمُكُمْ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاءِ. Give compassion to those who live with you on earth, and the one above the heavens will grant you his compassion. And therefore, as you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala today for his mercy, and as you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala today for his forgiveness, remember that it will begin by you being able to give mercy and forgiveness to others. What good is saying, Ya Rabbi Ighfirli, when your heart is closed to another human being? What good is saying, Ya Rabbi Ighfirli, when in your heart you say, I will never forgive her, I will never forgive him, I will never forget what they've done. I will only have that in my heart. I will never give them another chance. Never will they have a place with me again. La wallah. Your place with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala begins by in your heart finding the compassion that you seek from Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when you ask for Allah's generosity and you say, Ya Kareem, Ya Razzaq, use your rizq and use your generosity to others. When you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Sattar, oh Allah, conceal me, conceal for others. When you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Hayyu, Ya Qayyum, oh Allah, ever living, oh Allah, all sustaining, use your life and your ability to sustain, to assist and sustain others. Use the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in that in which way you seek of Him, and that is the greatest way of worshipping Allah. وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى فَادْعُوهُ بِهَا. To Allah are the most blessed names, so use them in your actions so that you can earn your way of worshipping Him subhanahu wa ta'ala through it. I conclude by asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from those who love our Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and that we prove that love through following His sunnah. And that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us the light of His guidance sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that we see it and practice it and follow it. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to open to us the doors of His mercy. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to encircle us with the angels. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bring upon us His tranquility, His sakina, and His rahmah. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us as hujjaj and the hujjaj that have joined us this year and in the coming years. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us to complete the hajj with safety and security. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to return us to our families with a forgiveness that has been descended from Him that none can give us and absolve us but Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow the light that He has sent to our Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the Quran, that it becomes a part of our life, and that it is recited by our tongues and seen daily by our eyes, and that its power is felt in our words and our footsteps. Allahumma ameen. I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala uses us as a proof of good towards others, and that the words and the deeds that we do are not a proof against us. Allahumma ameen. I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends upon us His guardian angels, and protects us from the harm of those who seek to harm us, and makes us from those who are protected in this life and the next. I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shelters us as we walk upon this earth, and as we return to Him in the moment of our death, and as we are entombed in the hour of Qabr. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to shelter us on the day of judgment, as we exit our grave to be standing before Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make this day a reminder for us of the day of judgment, that we remember the difficulties that we have endured in this journey, and that it reminds us to stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala evermore in our salat consistently in our life. I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes it easy for you and I to continue and to be devout in our prayers and that of our children and our generations that follow. رَبِّ جَعَلْنِي مُقِيمَ الصَّلَاةِ وَمِنْ ذُرِّيَّتِي رَبَّنَا وَتَقَبَّلْ دُعَاءِ. I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blesses us with children who continue the faith of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with the strength and better more than what we have. I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala leads us to a path of righteousness and keeps our feet planted on a sirat al-mustaqeem. I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descends upon us His rahmah and makes us from those who are utaqa min al-nar, freed from the punishment of Jahannam. Allahumma ja'alna utaqa'ika min al-nar. Allahumma ja'alna utaqa'ika min al-nar. Allahumma ja'alna min utaqa'ika min al-nar. Allahumma anzil alayna rahmata ya rabba al-alamin. اللهم انزل علينا رحمتك يا رب العالمين. اللهم انزل علينا رحمتك يا ارحم الراحمين. اللهم انصرنا. اللهم اهدنا. اللهم ثبتنا. اللهم انا نسالك خير هذا اليوم فتحه ونصره ونوره وهداه. والله we ask you for the good of this day, the opening and the conquest that you give us in this day, the blessings that you have set for us in this day. We ask you for the light of this day and the guidance that you send upon us this day. اللهم انا نعوذ بك من شر هذا اليوم وشر ما بعده. We ask you, O Allah, to protect us from any evil that we've tested in this day and what will come into the next day. اللهم امين. اللهم انا نسالك ايمانا لا يقبل ونعيما لا يقبل وقره عين لا تنقطع ومرافقه نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم في جنات النعيم. O Allah, we ask you to delight us with the look to our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on the day of judgment, that we are drawn closer to him and even as a drink from a kawthar. I ask you, O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to bless us with the shafa'ah of our Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and to make us from the first of people to enter Jannah with him, ya Allah. I ask you, O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to raise us to the level of the circles of the prophets with him, so I set them on our account of our love for him. Allahumma inna nas'aluka imanan la yardad wa na'iman la yambad wa qurratu adlin la tasada wa murafaqata nabiyyina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam li jannat al-na'im. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama sallayta ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك أنت الحميد المجيد. اللهم تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا يا مولانا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. اللهم ارزقنا البر والهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى. اللهم اهدنا واهدنا واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى. اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت ولينا ووليها يا مولانا. ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. ربنا عليك توكلنا وإليك أنبنا وإليك المصير. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا. ربنا ثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. ربنا ثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. ربنا ثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا. ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا. ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به. واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. ربنا إنا سمعنا مناديا ينادي للإيمان أن آمنوا بربكم فآمنا. ربنا فاغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا. ربنا فاغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار. ربنا توفنا مع الأبرار، ربنا توفنا مع الأبرار، ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما، ربنا اهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى، وصل اللهم وسلم وزد وبارك على سيدنا وحبيبنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم تقبل حج الحاجين، اللهم تقبل حج الحاجين، اللهم تقبل حج الحاجين، اللهم انصرنا يا ربنا في هذا اليوم المبارك، اللهم اجعلنا من عتقائك يا رب في هذا اليوم، يوم عرفة يا رب.